If you ask me, the CV industry has been facing a challenging times in the last 1.5 years. And you already said it briefly. But let me just dwell a little bit deeper into that. The major challenge has been on the demand side. In the last 5 years, the industry almost doubled its size, where in 2018 we had more than 378,000 trucks sold. And then in 2019, the industry took a complete U-turn and had a contraction of up to 35 to 40%. And there are very well-known reasons for that. You mentioned some of them, axle load norms implementation, GST. Then we had the liquidity crunch starting somewhere in end of 2018. And then when we also saw that the GDP growth, which used to be at a level of 7 to 8%, came down to 4 to 5% in 2019. Now, there is a very important point here which we must take note of. Axle load norms added about 25% additional capacity in the fleets. It was not only implemented for the new trucks sold, it was implemented for all the trucks which are running on Indian roads. And this is not a one-time correction. This is a permanent correction. If you look at GST norms, in our estimate, the fleet utilizations went up to 10% because of that. The turnaround time became better. And even if it leads to a short-term contraction in demand, we believe this is better for the industry. Right. Now, with that background, we stepped into 2020. And frankly, we were anticipating a 10% contraction in demand even in this year, simply because we were going to implement BS6 emission norms from 1st of April. And we have seen in other markets, Daimler is a worldwide player. We have seen that wherever we implement Euro 6 or equivalent norms, the industry in that year slows down by about 10%. This is also driven by the pre-buy which happens before the switch. Right? So the challenge on the demand side is going to be exceptionally high. Right? Now, keeping that in mind, what are the three areas of focus, according to me, for the entire industry? And this would be the three R's I will talk about. The first one is reboot. I think a good part of 2020 will keep us busy to reboot and stabilize our entire value chain. And when I say value chain, I'm talking about three aspects. One is on the supply chain or the supply side. The second is the value which we create inside our factories. And the third is on the distribution or on the sales side. So we all have to restart that very safely, maintaining the social distancing protocols, which we all know now, right? Let's keep in mind one more thing. Never ever before, it has been shut down so abruptly and restarted like that, right? So the safety of our employees has to be the number one priority for all of us, right? And we have to do it for the tier twos, the tier threes, and the dealer partners. So everyone has to restart in a very safe manner. We must help our stakeholders when we do that. We must support them. When we look at DICV, we paid entire full salaries for all our staff during the lockdown. We even paid all our contractual employees and the service providers. And I strongly believe that we have to remain socially responsible during this crisis, because the nature of the crisis is like that. The government cannot do everything. We all have to pitch in. So that's the first R, reboot. The second R is resilience. Like all other crises, let us also not let this one go waste, right? We have to cut down costs. We have to replan our investments, postpone or cancel what we don't need, but also continue to invest where we need to secure our long term. In a crisis of this nature, conserving cash becomes of paramount importance. So tie up your liquidity and make sure that you pay your suppliers in time. Another important thing will be to bring agility and execution. Why? Because we will all see very different scenarios playing out in front of us right now. So we should be agile to get adjusted to them when they arrive. And the third and the final R is reimagine. What do I mean by that? This crisis is a once in a century event. And events like this leave us with permanent change in the way we live our lives or we do our business. So you can't wait for the crisis to be over to start working on that. It is important to imagine right now what will change and start working on that. How will it impact us? What needs to be done to embrace this change? You know, I get reminded of what Charles Darwin had once said. It's not the smartest or the most intelligent who survive. It's always the one who are the most adaptable to change. So these are the three things which I would suggest that everyone focuses on in a crisis of this nature.